Hey VC, how's it going? Right, okay, I just want to show you some records that have come out this year, whether it be brand new releases or new reissues. There's been so much good stuff come out this year, and much of this stuff I haven't shown previously, so I thought it'd be quite a nice idea just to whiz through some of this. So first up, this is what I'm listening to in the background. This is Nubia Garcia and her debut album Source. Now, prior to this, she'd put out a couple of EPs over the last sort of few years or so. But this is, a first full-length album. And it's, for me, it's a real step up. I think she's the pick of the bunch when it comes to the current UK jazz scene. I do love her stuff. I love the whole vibe. It's an interesting mix. I mean, this track that I'm listening to, so this is the title track. It's a real nice fusion of jazz, reggae, dub. It sort of ticks all the boxes for me. So, yeah, very cool. I recommend this album. Really nice stuff. Right. Okay, so this album is Tim Burgess, and I love The New Sky. So this came out, must have been beginning of the year, because when we went into lockdown because of the whole COVID-19 thing back in March, this was my go-to album. And I was streaming it a hell of a lot of the time. I only picked up the vinyl copy of it in the middle of the year, but I was streaming this a lot of the time. Obviously, Tim Burgess lead singer with The Charlatans, so, well, The Charlatans UK, if you're in the States, there's another band called The Charlatans over there, isn't there? But yeah, so for me, The Charlatans have always been there. So sort of the early 90s were part of the whole Manchester thing. And then through the mid 90s, when Britpop took hold, there seemed to be part of that scene as well. And then into the early 2000s, when there's a real resurgence in guitar-based pop music, they were there again. So they've sort of all been there, always been there without, you know, ever going away, really. But or without ever doing anything really that different. You know, they've always got their own sort of sound going on. But this is very different. Rather than a guitar-based pop record, this is more like a 70s pop record. It really reminds me of the likes of 10cc, a little bit Steely Dan in places. Just really well-crafted pop songs with interesting instrumentation as well. There's fiddles in there, there's clarinet solos. Yeah, it's a little bit actually reminiscent of those sort of early 70s Beach Boys pop albums as well. So yeah, if you like that sort of thing, I'd definitely recommend this. And now with us going down, going into lockdown once again, this is the album that I've gone to once again. So yeah, really nice stuff. So this is High Tide Groove, a compilation. I didn't know what this was when I saw the Record Store Day list. I didn't actually go out on Record Store Day and pick anything up. These two things are stuff that I bought after the event, really. But this is a compilation of music recorded for High Records throughout the 70s, I think, and into 1980. Now, I've talked a lot about High Records recently, that whole Willie Mitchell production sound, sort of artists like Al Green, Ann Peebles, O.V. Wright. And what this does really well, it collects together some of the more obscure, sort of lesser-known tracks by those artists, but also includes a lot of tracks by artists that only recorded the odd single for the label. So included in there, you've got the likes of Africano and their wonderful song Satisfactorize Your Mind, which I'll do a needle drop on, but also stuff like Jean Plum. She only recorded two or three singles for the label, all of which are quite expensive to get a hold of now. I'd love copies, can't get hold of them, so this compilation really does the job. The only thing I'd say about it, I mean, it is a quiet pressing, but the music itself is a little bit muddy sounding. I don't know whether that's the original source material or whether it's the pressings, but I think the sound could be a little bit better. But overall, the packaging and the choice of tunes, excellent. So good stuff. Right. Okay. Now this is something that I saw Mark, Dr. Rhythm, show in a recent video, the video that he did with Paul. XL Junkie NLX, yeah, I never get his name right. Okay, so so this is the Grodek Whipperjenny. Did I get that right? The Grodek Whipperjenny, yeah. So this is from 1972, I think. And it's interesting because I bought this, I saw Mark show it, and it just sounded right up my street. So I got a copy of it online, and I put a picture of it on the Instagram page. And loads of people commented saying, yeah, I love that record. They got original copy or whatever, you know, they knew what it was. I didn't have a clue what it is prior to Mark showing it. So a bit of background. This album and this album were recorded at the same time, pretty much by the same musician. So bizarrely, I've had this album for a number of years. This is James Brown, Show His Funky Down Here. One of my favorite James Brown records. It's instrumental, but it's that mix of funk, but almost a little bit of psych going on in there. There's a lot of that sort of fuzz tone guitar going on. I thought I'd say this is 1972. Ironically, James Brown doesn't actually play on it that much. I think he's only on two or three tracks. But the band is killer. And the same band recorded this. So the guy that arranged both of these records is a guy called David Matthews. He was an arranger for James Brown around this sort of period, late 60s, early 70s. And how the records came about were that in the mid 60s, James Brown got a real mixed following. So a lot of blacks and whites mixed at his gigs. He wasn't just reliant on a black audience, but as the decade went on and into the 70s, he noticed the white audience disappear. So he felt that he needed more of an underground sound, something to appeal to a white audience, to bring, you know, the students back in, that sort of thing. And he asked Dave Matthews to put together a couple of albums under that sound. So one in his name, and the other project was to be in Dave Matthews' name. The two sit alongside each other really well. Obviously, this is that sort of funky, sort of psyche sound. This has that, but more as well. So it's a little bit jazzy in places. It's also a little bit sort of musical theatre, you know. It's a bit Age of Aquarius at times, you know. It's that sort of vibe going on. But both lovely records. I can't believe I never heard of this record before, but really pleased to pick it up. Right, and I'm just going to finish on a couple more reissues. Now, another album which has been shown by every man and his dog, I think, over the last couple of months. I've seen like sort of five or six people show this now. This is J.R. Bailey and Just Me and You. So this is a soul record from 1974. A soul record from 1974 that I'd never even heard of before. And it is an absolute killer record from start to finish. I think it was Market Dr. Rhythm who described it as being having the vibe of What's Going On, you know, the Marvin Gaye record. But rather than being about sort of social political issues, it's all about love. And that's a perfect description of it. It's got that whole sort of vibe. The songs sort of drift into each other. Really nice stuff. Great vocalist. He was a songwriter. So I don't know if this is his debut album, but I know he put out a lot of 7-inches, a lot of 45s prior to this. But I think this might have been his debut album. But he's written for other artists. One of the tracks on here, the opening track on side two, Love, 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 was recorded by Donny Hathaway. I have Donny Hathaway's version of it. And then J.R. Bailey went back and used the song again for this album. So, yeah, once again, a great album. Sounds brilliant as well, the pressing. It's on B With Records, who always do a good job. So, yeah, lovely stuff. And just one other record on B With. This is The Optimistics. This is a soul album from 1970. Again, I'll do a needle drop on this. It's that sort of early 70s sweet soul. But again, all of the songs are good. I buy so many soul records, certainly around this sort of period, where when you listen to them, there's a handful of good tracks. This is all good. And again, it's on B With. The pressing's really nice. I'll do another drop on that. So, cheers. Thank you.
just no go.
Just sit here on the dock.